Hello, my name is Christian. I like to build stuff. Usually I build magic props because I'm a magician. I'm also a high school teacher and I build weird stuff for all kinds of things. In this video, I'm going to take this cheap cigar box guitar that I bought because I thought that cigar box guitars are quite cool, and it's a fun way to start getting into cigar box guitars. But I want to build a real one at some point. But right now I thought it could be cool to do a little work on this because the box here is actually just cardboard. You can almost see the white paper-like stuff inside here. The fretboard without frets actually just lines, and it drawings on the fretboard, but it actually works. You can play something on this. It's a kind of bluesy thing. It has this piezo pickup inside, and you play it with a bottleneck, and that's not something that I'm particularly good at. But before I invest a ton of time in learning how to play a cigar box guitar, I think it could be fun to dive into this one a little bit. But a cardboard box, that's kind of ridiculous. So I want to take this one apart, and instead I'm going to put it into a real cigar box. I'm just gonna flip the screen here. Okay, you can get a better look at the guitar now. I'm going to put it into this cigar box. It's an old one. Bridge or whatever. I'm going to decorate it later, but as you can see, it's not quite as big as the cardboard box that comes with it, already is on the guitar, but it fits within the dimensions. I can get the bridge here in the right spot. The fretboard will be a little bit longer, but in this guitar, the box itself has no structural use at all. The fretboard goes all the way through as one piece of wood, and this is just glued on to this groove that is in the fretboard. So I can just take this, cut this box off. Take the piezo pickup and pry it off. It's glued under here, I know. And then I'm going to cut a hole in this thing and place it in here and glue this back into the lid of this. And then I'm going to decorate the box. So I'm going to show how I'm doing that. All right, first I'm going to take off the strings here. When I strung this back in the day, I got it, actually I got it a couple of years ago. Never really got into it because I thought this cardboard box were kind of ridiculous. So I left all the excess strings on it. All right, so far so good. Now I'm going to open this this box, and I need to be a little bit careful that I don't cut any wires here for the pickup. I'm just going to unscrew the jack. Push it into there so that nothing gets I'm just gonna cut one side off on my bandsaw over here. You can see it's just heavy duty cardboard here, and inside here the pickup is glued to the, it's not easy to see now, it's not that easy to see. I'm going to take it off this this way, cut it open. Just held together with this kind of contact paper, and then the inside of the bends here, so it's really not a very solid thing. But of course, what can you expect for practically nothing? Wasn't very expensive. Okay, you can see now here the pickup is just glued on here. And I think I can just take it off like this. And this will just be glued back on the new piece inside the new cigar box. And as you can see, the fretboard here is just glued on here. So I'm just going to take this off. So that's what's left here. And this paper is very practically not even glued onto this board. I need to make sure that this rises just a little bit above the deck here. And it goes in like this, so this part here is just up above the. So I need to measure where I'm going to cut, and as you can see, this I don't have to cut into the bottom of the box, I just have to cut into the lid, which is very nice because it makes it easier. And actually, when I measure, I can see that I only have to cut up until this edge here. So this piece up here, and that will provide some structural integrity, I think. So so I'm going to measure that out. Maybe I can just eyeball it here. Gonna eyeball it on the other side, and I'm going to measure that. Just be very. Pretty good eyeballing. So now I need to cut this piece out here. Get the finest cut with a hacksaw, actually.
using this little saw for the final approach to the deck. Like that. So. I think I might be able to tap it out with one of these. Just like that. Need a little bit of sanding. Now I need to cut out a small groove in the glass. Now I need to cut out a small groove in the deck here, so it fits. And I'm going to measure from the inside here, because that's where it will be. It's easiest to see the marks here, and I think I might be able to this on the bandsaw. Yes. Just need mm-hmm. like this. So inside the cigar box, there's these panels that can actually be taken out, but they help giving the box some extra strength. So I'm actually going to glue them in, but this part over here and over here needs to get a groove cut, and these parties I can take that out and do that on the bandsaw. Want to get it to the top, because then it can glue the lid shut if it's not. Entirely. And I'm just going to put this clamp in for a short while, because as soon as the other ones come back into the box, it reinforces itself. Thank you. just like that. So a lot closer to a cigar box guitar. There should in the cardboard box there was like a music key hole in it, and that would be quite cool to put into this one, but the problem is that I don't think it's that easy to put in. I have another idea, but I'm a little bit afraid it might not be possible. But I have this idea of putting like one of these into the mix. Trouble is that I have to, in order to fit it, I have to actually cut into the fretboard. I'm not sure that's such a good idea, and I'm not sure. I think I like the. So maybe I have to cut a hole. I could use this as a template. Use this as a template. How would that look? Cool thing about putting a hole in it is that it gives the box some of the sound a possibility of actually escaping the resonance chamber in here. I'm not entirely sure what to do. I've been doing some measuring here, and I think I'm going to put in two of these, one here and one here, because they will allow these are inserts for water taps, and yeah. There's a plastic stuff in here that I can take out, but there's this mesh strainer that will allow the sound to come out, and I think it would be a good way to do it. Just need to find the right size drill bit. this forstner bit here that I'm going to use. So I'm going to measure out where these should be. Just going to again eyeball the first placement. Then I'm going to measure out the placement for the other side. Just going to set it. I'm gonna drill the holes for these, and I'm not gonna show you that because that's where the camera is right now, and I don't really have another place to put the camera while I'm drilling, so I guess you know how drills work. I just put a piece of wood on the inside to reinforce while I'm drilling. Two holes. And these are a perfect fit actually, which is nice. So this looks kind of nice, I think. So I need to find the place to put the nut. On the old cardboard box, there's this cross right here where the bridge is going to be situated. So I'm just going to measure that. First, I'm going this little marking here should be the place. So far so good. I need to put in the piezo pickup. I'm going to see if I can get this bit of glue pried off it. It's just a bit of hot glue, and I'm going to do this, use the same for putting it back into the new box. And I need to make a place for the jack plug. I could put it in the back, I could put it in the bottom, and I could put it in the back here, could put it in the bottom here. Or I could put it into the lid, so everything is, and I think it would maybe look kind of cool to have it sticking out here. I'm not sure. Maybe it's better to put it down here. So need to find a bit. Hole needs to be a little bit bigger. Probably I have a little bit bigger. As you can see, because of the thickness of the material here, plus this piece that I put in and glued in earlier. The jack plug in here doesn't come all the way out, so I can mount the bolt onto it, and I think that might be a problem. So I think I'm going to, this is not in, just going to cut this off. Took this piece off, that's okay. And I need to just make a little bit of an indentation in here, and I have this this countersink thing here that I can make a groove with. Doesn't need to be very pretty on the inside. But might as well just clean it up a little bit. Much better. So I just put in this and the bolt thing here. Then this will go right here, so it, and I'm going to put it all the way up by this, by the, so it doesn't get stuck on this one. I'm not going to open and close it very much, but before I do that, I think I'm going to glue this down into the cigar box bottom here now. glue gun here. To put in the pickup, and also to fasten these. Just going to get these plastic thingies out here. This. Just pull the plastic out of these so the sound will be able to get out of the box. So just waiting for the glue gun, and then I'm going to let this set. The glue needs to cure, and then I will be decorating and putting strings on again, and hopefully plugging it in and doing some a little bit of playing. I'm not very good at it, but this is the start, I think. Right. Well, the video timed out while I was working, and I kind of, well, stringed the guitar. I lost one of these small. I think actually they are rivet. Pieces of rivets, but one of them fell to the floor and couldn't find it. So in order to avoid the strings digging into the wood on the backside, I put this antique looking bracket on. Then I put the bridge in and stringed it. And already now I think it's kind of cool looking. I also put a screw here and a screw here in order to be able to put a string on it so I can, you know, wear it, playing it, standing up. But I need to put some stickers on it, I think, or some
maybe some traveling stickers or something like that to decorate it. But for now, it needs to be tuned and be played.